Barakatha Yahweh Shai. I want to give all praise to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem, or Kakadash. I want to give double honors to the elders and the apostles and great millstone. And barakatham to all you brothers as I teach in this truth with faith and sincerity across the four corners of the earth. Okay, and I want to go into how only the 144,000 elect can receive this truth, okay? Two-thirds of our people, two-thirds of the Israelites are going to die right here in America, okay? When this place is destroyed off the face of the earth, okay? But only the 144,000 can get this truth, man. It only resonates with the elect, man, okay? And I want to go ahead and jump right into a scripture. Okay, Proverbs chapter 8, verse 33, okay? Hear instruction and be wise and refuse it not. And two-thirds of our people have heard this truth and chose to stay in the world. They refused this truth, man, because it wasn't meant for them, man. Only 144,000 elect can get this truth, man. Blessed is the man that heareth me, watching daily at my gates, waiting at the post of my doors, man. And mainly the prophets, man, that's watching for the return of Yahweh Shai, man. Okay? Blessed is the man that heareth me, watching daily at my gates, man. And we watching all the signs. We watching the news. We looking at the mark of the beast, man. Watching all these different countries starting to turn their back on America, which is Babylon the Great. And pretty soon, man, the economy, the stock markets and shit, they finna plummet, man. And they gonna send this place into hell, man. And they just waiting on that big event, okay? That big event that they gonna stage a false flag, if you will. And it's going to be way bigger than 9/11, man. Okay? Because they need an excuse to implement martial law, man. They need an excuse to implement them Noahide laws, man. Them seven Noahide laws, man. Okay? And I also want to go ahead and go to Proverbs. Chapter 22, okay? Proverbs chapter 22, verse 3, okay? A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, okay? But the simple pass on and are punished, man. And they're going to be punished with these nuclear missiles that is going to hit Babylon the Great, man. A prudent man foreseeth the evil, man, and hideth himself. How does he hide himself? By immersing himself in this truth, man. By doing the work or by being faithful and just having faith, to be honest, okay? Just having faith in following the laws to the best of your ability, man. Okay? Because this thing, man, is going to take you people as the Lord says he's coming back as a thief in the night, man. Matter of fact, let me go get 1 Thessalonians, okay? 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. And, start at verse 2, man. For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction come upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. But ye, brethren, are not in darkness that day should overtake you as a thief, man. Because we watching, man. We watching for the return of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, man. So it's not going to take the 144,000 as a thief in the night. Why? It's because we know it's coming, man. We know our Lord's coming back, man. We know he's coming to destroy America, Babylon the Great. Okay? We know he's coming to put these Edomites in fucking chains for 1,000 years, man. Okay? So, brothers, just stay strong, man. Just have faith. Continue to watch for prophecies, man. Continue to stay in the scriptures, man. Okay? And with that, I want to give all praise to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah Bashem, Rakakadash. I want to give double honors to the elders and the apostles and great millstone. And shalom to the hopefully elect. I hope you're edified.